INF library, LIB, information library, inlib net, information library net. This is there in Ahmedabad, where this Esho the Sindhu, Esho the Ganga. If you know now, about 2 lakhs of theses have been harvested in InfLibNet at Ahmedabad. So therefore, you don't have a problem of resources today. That's what I want to tell a friend for literature. Anything that you want to search, you find the right keyword, find out, so much will come. The only thing is you have to refine your search and get some useful information and do your literature survey. So literature survey, I would say today is much easier than what it has started. It was about 30, 40 years ago. So therefore, if you want to get a useful scientific literature, know what you have, what has been done by others. Do not reinvent. That's why don't reinvent the wheel necessarily. You don't have to spend waste your time. You know, you can talk to some senior member. No. These papers are there. These 5 papers you can build up. You read this. You go there. It's a very comfortable zone for all of you. Understand, as I already told, your field. Unless you know what your field is, you cannot do literature survey. Because which one you search for? In the whole globe, what do you search unless you know? So therefore, do not try to solve all problems in the field. Pick out what is that one small problem that I can solve. Therefore, that is important. Small advancement lead to the critical development. Even a delta change that you can do in the literature, in the publication, it is great. So past, I already told, we used to get from C-mail, 6 months to get a reprint. If author is happy to send one, and already I shared TA for Bombay, BRC, IIT Madras. I used to travel by train in 1970s to go and then see the literature. We are all blessed. In present, as already mentioned, digital libraries are there, virtual platforms are there, Esho the Sindhu, Esho the Ganga, books are available today, free books are available in Karnataka. Now today, pandemic, they have said, Karnataka government, you don't have to buy a book. They have given a site where up to 1st standard to 12th standard, PDF format things are there. You ask your friend to print and give it to you in some institution, some faculty. So therefore, this is the way we are. And also you have gate, J-gate. This is another thing where, the library you must be having or you have it. The idea with J-gate is, that will search all over the country where it is available, IAC, IIT, NIT, it will tell. And the additional advantage that you have if you subscribe, for JGate, there, they suppose the article is available IIT Madras, if you send a message, it's all automatic, the librarian of IIT Madras will send the, if you are a member of the InfLibNet, which is very nominal, and you become, and you get a reprint to your librarian at Government Engineering College, Pansara. Are you a member of the InfLibNet? Dr. Bansal or Dr. Shubham, please answer me.
Are yes, anyone sir. Who
is you are a member?
Yeah, VOG member.
No, J-Gate.
Sorry, sir. J-Gate.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
Yeah. So the J-Gate I was discussing, the J-Gate, if you search an article which is available in IIT Bombay, there is a provision to send a mail to IIT Bombay librarian, an article will come to you if you are a member of the InfLibNet. If you are a very nominal member, 5,000 rupees or something like that. Hey, if you are, please check your librarian. You unmute. You mute your things. My dear participants, one of you, thank you. So you please become the member and you will get all the resources. That's what I wanted. And also, there is one wonderful thing available, World E-Library, free of cost. You can go to your mobile and check. World E-Library, if you want to read something nice article about, nice thing about Einstein, you go to World Library, it is available. All the things, copyright, over, they harvested in the E-Library. Government of India, when I was there in the National Committee, we added all these things in the World E-Library subscription. So it is available. Somebody has muted. Please unmute. So use that. So still one participant is not muted. South Asian Archives, which is also a very important thing, is available. 20 crore money has been spent by MHRD. So I am just gave you, and there is one more research, you know, those who cannot afford money, you know, they have gone to court and all that, but they are still fighting it illegally. Research Gate, you must have heard. If you want to search any article in the Research Gate, free of cost, you can do that. So therefore, finally do the literature survey by all the resources that are available today, then do gap analysis and define your problem. So hitherto what I have said is, I told what research is, how do we define research, what are the characteristics of research, what are the problem associated with research, how do we make a research problem, how do we do literature survey, how do we understand the area first, how do we narrow down, how do we do literature with various resources available, and at the end of it, do gap analysis, make 2, 3, 4 objectives. This is what I want to do, and start your research. I wish all of you would take this, would start your research. This is what I was saying. Books are there for your literature, journals are there, databases are there. You know, Science Direct gives you so much. Full texts are there, abstracts are available, and internet, you know, area today, you have so many pieces, and you show, already show you show the Ganga, you show the Sindhu, InfliPNet, this is what I was talking, Information Library Net is available, where you can get all your journals through by becoming a member. You are a government organization, I think if I am right, it is about 5,000 rupees for membership, please become, you get so much of resources from them. So point to keep in mind while doing research is read the relevant literature. Don't spend time what is not relevant. Refer the original works. That is very, very important. Read with comprehension, you know, understanding. Comprehension is understanding. Read, one reading may not make you understand. Read again if it is very useful to you. Comprehend. Comprehension is very important. In the Bloom taxonomy, remember the concept and then understand them. Then apply them. Then analyze them. The same Bloom 6 level you need to adopt even here in research. So the you remember your Bloom cognitive, remember, understand, apply, analyze, and finally you go to create. You know, that is what research is all about. So and again, already I told you, read in time. Don't take ticket after train is left. Suppose if you read this article after 6 months, it is no use. Index your literature, whatever you do, otherwise it becomes very difficult to handle yourself. Okay, so I will not get into the 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th and all that. So what I possibly spend another, I have 5-10 minutes. I have spent 1 hour, can I take another 5-10 minutes after Shivlan? Dr. Shubham, Dr. Bansal.
Bansal is here.
Dr. Bansal, can I take another 5-10 minutes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So having done the literature survey, the, you know, I will not spend, I will send formulation of the hypothesis is important. You know, I will, you know, there is going to be a, one more talk on this, and then problem definition, as I told you. Then finally, you know, what is important in hypothesizing, I will tell you. What you are conceptually, you have to be very clear and precise. Specificity is important. Specific, limited to this scope. Consistency, you know, research is about these 5, that's why I'm putting this slide. Conceptual clarity is important, specificity is important, consistency is important, testability is important, expectancy is important. So therefore, specific and limited, consistent, capable of being tested. If you do something which is not testable, is no use, state the expected relationship, that is called expectancy, expectation, that is important. Okay, so just a couple of seconds, give me, you know. Yeah, this always I put it, you know, because I enjoy it. Now let me come to some applied research. You know, generic, in like 5 minutes, I want to talk to all my engineering friends. As all of you know, whether you are a civil engineer, mechanical engineer, or computer engineer, electronics engineer, whatever engineering, today, you know, not that 8 I am talking, the next 5 minutes will be important. So many things are there, but these are picking up very, very high. Now let me tell you, research is now is interdisciplinary. You cannot now first tell, I'm a physicist, I'm a chemist, I'm a mathematician, I'm a civil engineer, I'm a mechanical engineer. All boundaries are going off. Now let us say, I give an example, nanoscience. Nanoscience, you need everybody. physicist, chemist, electronics, mechanical engineer, civil, nanoscience and engineering, if you want to do all works of, the boundaries are going. Earth science, you need civil engineers, you need geologists, you need physicists, you need everybody. And the chemists, mathematicians. And if you want, let us say one more example, if you want to give neuroscience. Neuroscience, you need biologists, you need mathematician, you need computer science, and so on. So therefore, technology is leading today. So today's research will be tomorrow's technology. And you know, whatever we understood 100 years ago, it becomes a reading material for a high school or today. So therefore, why I am telling you is future technologies are important. So I am giving some clues where possible, not that you should take area of research in this only. There are hundreds of areas in which you can pursue. But the, you know, as all of you know, the artificial intelligence, as I already mentioned many times, is very, very important. Today, in the next 10, 15 years, a lot of things will happen. So therefore, what my advice would be is, if you want to do some research in this area, try to get acquainted with, here again, artificial intelligence, you require mechanical engineers, you need civil engineers. You want to use artificial intelligence in the agriculture, you need civil. So artificial intelligence is used across health sector, agriculture, or you know, infrastructure, anything you name, education. So therefore, anything, you know, you do some good literature survey in this area, find out. Today, artificial in education, if I want to give, I have already told you, today proctor system. You can conduct exam, we not being there, you know, the challenge of the next 4 months, our challenge is to conduct the exam offline. Oh, they may copy, you know, today you can see, you know, the technologies have gone so much. If I am there in the camera is better than an invigilator in the room of 20 students. Where invigilator is going, if there is no student, it takes another 2 minutes to come back to me, he will do the copying. But in the camera, even if you do for 1 or 2 seconds, even for to pick up a pen, it will detect and then alert. So therefore, proctor system for exam, artificial intelligence being used. So I just give few examples though, but you can think of in your area many things. Now another area where you know lot of things can be done is 3D printing. 3D printing, as all of you know, is an additive manufacturing, product design, huge potential for mechanical engineering with all the other associated computer science, electronics. Many things can be done in this. Augmented virtual reality is coming up. As all of you know, the challenge is to suppose theory you can do online class. How do you perform experiment? To some extent, some simulation experiment you can do through your, let us say, simulation. Some experiment, all the experiment cannot be conducted. So therefore, this virtual reality and augmented reality will make you to perform the experiment so that others can share. So therefore, in the next, you know, many years, this augmented and virtual reality are being used in health sector, education, very, very, you know, frequently. Autonomous vehicle, driverless, they are thinking. I don't know if it's still possible in India. But what is important in India next 5-10 years is to work on electric, motors. Now, petrol may not be available. Diesel, nobody wants pollution. So therefore, electric vehicles are picking up. The electric stations will come. In Gujarat, you have seen all the gas, natural gas. Now, you know, things are changing. So electric vehicles will be the order of the day 10, 15 years down the line. Hyperloop, you know, very interesting area in Europe, it is happening. Now people don't want to spend 6 hours to go from Sweden to France. They want to go in 30 minutes. So therefore, underground, they are making the way where it can go with the speed, which is unimaginable. I can go from Bangalore to Delhi, which a flight takes 2.5 hours, which they want to go in 30 minutes, 20 minutes. That kind of a technologies are being done. And as all of you, blockchain is picking up. Now, all the transactions today, you know, COVID has not stopped. People, you know, are healthy. They are not going to a doctor. Therefore, you know, the blockchain, you know, the transactions are happening. Just not transaction happens in the blockchain. Blockchain is a huge area in the management field. That, you know, genetic thing, you know, we want all 135 crore people genetic or unique. That is an area which is also picking up those who are interested in biology. And last, the smart city. You know, 100 cities have been identified by Government of India. Huge potential to do research in this. So I just wanted to give you as a flavor of these 8 areas which have got high potential in technology wise to take up the applied research in the. So therefore, I would say that again in the research, you know, one isolation you cannot do. To achieve research, you have to come. Quality is important. So to achieve the quality, what is required? You have to come together. So we need to work together, collaborate with each other, tolerate the differences, respect the diverse views, because none of us is as smart as all of us. So teamwork is always, I keep saying, whether it's teaching or research or anything, I'm sure that this is extremely important. So thank you very much for your patience hearing. I thought I tried to give you in the last 90 minutes to give some glimpse of what research is and where we can do and what are the potential. So now over to Dr. Shubham.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, to you. Any questions they can ask?
You can, they can ask. All participants are requested to please ask the question if you want. Any participant, you want to ask any question?
The chat box they can write. At least 3-5 questions I can.
Yeah, sir. One question is.
Yeah, please read the question.
Yes, sir. One question is copy paste problem, sir. Sir, most of the research scholars prefer to copy paste a lot of things from others in their research work, so their thesis cannot be perfect one. How can this bad habit and mentally of the scholar can be checked? What is your opinion about this?
Very, very, you know, good question. Very important question. Yeah, the tendency they call human tendency. If something is there, I know that it is not my property, but I want to, you know, some pen on the. You know, I'll just give a simple example. So there is a pen. Let us say you see. On the table, you know, I have seen in my own chamber, somebody has come, he diverted my moment and picked one pen from my box. Then, you know, I caught it. Then he said, sir, this pen is very, very good. I want to take. He could have told you in the beginning. If you were to tell me, I would have given you as a small memento, having come to me with. So therefore, you know, human tendency is that, but you know, ethics is important. You remember I told you the story of Sir C.V. Raman, but for honesty, Chandrasekhar would not have become the Nobel laureate. So therefore, the mindset should change. You know, don't quote me. Now it's being recorded or not recorded? Okay, sir, even if it doesn't matter, I'll tell you one of the story. You know, it's all right. The governor of Andhra Pradesh called me and made a constituted committee where I was a chairman, and then two from IIT Madras and IIT Hyderabad asked me, because one of the complaint given by one of the institution principal of one college, there is nothing wrong, I can share, I will not tell the names. So the principal has written a thesis at the age of 55 and he got the PhD, and the another fellow who wanted to become a principal gave a complaint to the governor saying that this principal has done plagiarism. Okay, so then the investigation started, and after the investigation, then finally after 2 years, it came to the high level committee. You don't believe, when we have gone through, three of us were batting, one of the German theses written in Germany has been translated to English and submitted and got the PhD. Is it fair? So why I gave this example is, I think that, you know, he wanted to become a principal of a college. As all of you know, in the country, to become a principal or a professor, you need a PhD. Are we doing satisfying somebody? Are we doing research or not? So why the message that I like to give is, we should do research for our sake, not to satisfy AICD, not to satisfy UGC, not to satisfy somebody. You know, there is a slogan in South India, if you do BSc, you get 10 lakhs dowry. If you do MSc, you get 20 lakhs dowry. if you do PhD, you get 50 lakhs dowry. So do you do PhD to get 50 lakhs dowry from the girl side? We should not. So research, PhD according to me is only a foundation. You have to build up, you have to enjoy. The kind of enjoyment you get after publishing a paper is enormous. So therefore, to my friend who has asked the question, I congratulate him. Very pertinent question. Any BTech project, they will prepare in one day. Cut and paste and give it. Guide also will close his eyes and sign. And examiner also will give you 95 marks out of 100. So I think, you know, the fair assessment should be done. Fair training. You know, idea is for a BTech project is to tell him what a project is, how do I learn. That is more important, not the marks that he gets. So therefore, my request is, in future, with future technology, plagiarism cannot be done. We have to get rid of that plagiarism from our mind. Come what may, I will not China do this. That is the only solution. Thank you, my dear friend, who has asked that question. Very good question. Hope I have answered.
Sir, one question is other more. Can we complete international level in research work after NEP 2020 implementation before 2035, as our research work are very poor than the other countries?
Okay. Now, the poor and good is all relative. If yep. I call myself poor, I will be poor. If I call I am happy. See, the happy is a happy. Some people I have seen in the slum, they are the happiest people in the world. They know how to earn 50 rupees, 100 rupees, rupee. In the 50 rupees, 10 rupees, darshini, they go and have the breakfast, enjoy the breakfast to the core. I have seen, when my wife was not there, I went to darshini, I really enjoyed them taking one dosa and then, you know, relishing. This is what I think the mental block. See, NEP says the research and teaching should go hand in hand. Okay, I promise that I'll be giving a talk, then I will talk more. But at this point, because answer to the simple answer to the question that he has asked is the following. We are not poor. India is a great country. India has got a great researcher. And if you want to do academics, people say you go to Australia, America. If you want adventurous, you can go to Australia. If you want to do invention, be in India. I for India, I for invention. We are in a, you know, so therefore, India is a great country, and you know, the Yavan is there in India, in Banswara. So a man, Dr. Bansal, sitting there, has written SCI papers. If he can do, I think we are not poor. That is my answer.
Thank you, sir.
We all can.
So anyone question? So thank you very much, sir, for informative and very nice full lecture, and I think all of you are enjoying of this lecture. So thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And next, all participants, next session will be start at 1:30 p.m. by Professor Jagdeep Singh from JCRC University, Jaipur. And this topic is how to write a good research scientific paper.
Very good.
Thank you all of you, and we will meet at 1:30 p.m. Okay. Thank you.
I can see 86 people have attended here, and then many must have come from social media.
Yes, sir.
I'm very happy. I wish each one of them have to have a great day. Have your lunch. No lunch is given because of the virtual world. So sorry to say that, but you can have e-copy. You know, e-copy, e-journal, e-show the Sindhu, like that. You know, everything is e-maya. So you have it. Enjoy. Have a great day. And I wish the next session a very successful one. And also I wish this webinar for the next 2 days, and a very wonderful concept. And I wish this event to have a great output from these 3 webinars. I once again take the opportunity to thank Dr. Shivlal, Dr. Bansal, Dr. Shubham, and all my dear friends at Bansara, and for giving me this opportunity. And wish you all a very best, and take care. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Can I take care?
Bye. Yes, sir. Thank you. Very much.
Bye. 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 Bye, Dr.
Sir.
Kant is smiling with, you know, yes.